Can this insane nuclear propulsion plan take us to Mars and beyond? Traveling to Mars and building a settlement there is the new goal of this space race. But let's be quite honest, sending humans to Mars isn't an easy task. 50 years ago was the last time humans were on the moon. We should have had a moon settlement by now. When it comes to Mars, though, there's a reason why we haven't explored the red planet and why only a few landers have made the trip. There are many problems lying in the deep depths of space that make a voyage to Mars oh so tough. Gary Flandreau, a young Caltech graduate student, was poring over his notes in Building 180 of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in 1965, studying the intricacies of using planets' gravitational fields to slingshot spacecraft into the outer reaches of space with no need for additional propellant, the gravity assist, a method of propulsion that uses the gravity of a gravitational body to literally pull the spacecraft into a new trajectory and velocity, as he examined. In the late 1970s, Gary saw something incredible. A window would open up where the alignment of the planets would allow a single satellite to pinball its way through Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune before being ejected out to the furthest regions. With this information, a frenzy of activity erupted within NASA and JPL. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity had been discovered that would not occur again for another 175 years, and it was critical that the opportunity shouldn't be wasted. Planning began, and in 1977, two satellites, Voyager 1 and 2, would launch aboard a three-stage Titan IIIe rocket. Voyager 2 would use a gravity assist with Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus before racing by Neptune before eventually exiting the solar system. Voyager 1 completed a more direct path. Today, as species, we have left our marks all over the solar system and beyond. Voyager 1 took 35 long years to reach the end of our solar system. Even though we can build these spacecrafts and send them to other worlds to explore with gravity assist methods, sending ourselves in space and to other planets is a completely different thing. We cannot use a method like gravity assist to travel to other planets. 35 years is a long time for a human. So far, the furthest humans have traveled into space is to the dark side of the moon, which is just 400,000 kilometers away. If our goals to establish colonies on Mars are to be realized, we will need quicker and more efficient spacecraft than we presently have. Humans aren't accustomed to staying in space for so long. The Hohmann transfer technique with launch windows every 26 months is the quickest and most efficient way we know for reaching Mars, and it takes around 9 months to accomplish. A round trip would take about 21 months to complete. We would need to spend thousands of dollars a second just to get to the red planet and would have to sacrifice a large amount of payload, based upon our current technology, and not to mention the kind of impact such a long trip would have upon human psychology. But what if there was another way? What if there was a way that wouldn't take 21 months to complete a trip to Mars? What if it could be done in a mere 3 days? Are there new methods of propulsion that can change this for us? Let's take a look at where our current technology is right now. Ever since the start of the space race, chemical rockets have been the most commonly used propulsion method. Current rockets use chemical combustion to propel themselves, which is a method in which a fuel and an oxidizer are combined in a combustion chamber and ignited, causing the combustion products to rapidly heat up and expand. The nozzle design then directs the expanding gas in one direction to achieve thrust. Today, SpaceX is one of the most technologically advanced companies, and the kind of tech they have is far better than any other company. One of the first pioneers to go to Mars, Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, is building Starship to take humans to Mars. SpaceX is currently working on their Raptor engines, which are known for the ridiculous amount of thrust they produce. They plan to replace it by the Raptor 2.0, which will be a major improvement in the Raptor engines. But what makes SpaceX different is their rapid reusability, which no other company has achieved as of right now. The Raptor 2 engine, which is currently being developed, is a critical piece of SpaceX's future. It has a radical amount of power cultivated in ways never before used with the science and reusability factor. The Raptor engine is what space engineers have always dreamed of but have never been capable of achieving before now. It will save money, it will save energy, and it will help massive vessels like the Starship transcend our atmosphere and head straight for Mars. But there's still a problem with this technology. Even though with Starship, we wouldn't have to sacrifice payload weight and it's far superior than any other technology in the past, the journey to Mars would still take 9 months in each direction. This is where a nuclear-powered rocket has the opportunity to truly transform space travel for humanity. Even though they cause controversy on Earth, nuclear reactors can supply the energy and power required to swiftly transport big spacecraft to Mars, and if desired, beyond. Nuclear rocket engines were first proposed in the 1940s. This time, though, proposals for interplanetary trips fueled by nuclear fission and fusion are backed by new designs that have a considerably higher chance of success. Importantly, the nuclear engines are exclusively intended for interplanetary flight, not for usage in the Earth's atmosphere. Chemical rockets propel the spacecraft beyond low Earth orbit. The nuclear propulsion mechanism is activated only then. Nuclear thermal propulsion uses the energy provided by nuclear processes to heat liquid hydrogen to around 2,430 degrees Celsius, which is almost 8 times the temperature of nuclear power plant cores. The propellant rapidly expands and jets out the nozzles. When compared to chemical rockets, this can create double the thrust per mass of fuel, allowing nuclear-powered ships to go longer and faster. Furthermore, once reaching the destination, whether Saturn's moon Titan or Pluto, the nuclear reactor could transition from propulsion to power supply, allowing the probe to transmit back high-quality data for years. This means it can also allow us to reach Mars in a mere 90 days. But some people have their skepticism about this method, thanks to all the nuclear disasters like Chernobyl and Cosmos 954. Given the past events, it's no doubt people would be cynical about this method. However, it is a very safe method, and there are specific safeguards in place to prevent any type of radiation leakage or exposure. And for an added layer of safety, any nuclear-powered ship would actually rely on an old-fashioned chemical rocket to get out of our atmosphere, and it would only be once the ship left the Earth that it would begin using its nuclear power. In the fiscal year 2021 budget bill, NASA received $110 million for nuclear thermal propulsion development. Obtaining adequate thrust from a nuclear rocket used to need the employment of weapons-grade, highly enriched uranium. Low-enriched uranium fuels, which are utilized in commercial power plants, are safer to use, but they can become brittle and fall apart when subjected to the intense temperatures and chemical salts of the extremely reactive hydrogen. However, ultra-safe Nuclear Corp Technologies, USNC Tech, a company based in Seattle, uses uranium fuel enriched to less than 20%, which is of higher quality than that used in power reactors, but can't be diverted for nefarious purposes. So it greatly reduces proliferation risks, according to Director of Engineering Michael Eads. The fuel used by the firm is made up of small ceramic-coated uranium fuel particles spread in a zirconium carbide matrix. The microcapsules contain radioactive fission byproducts while allowing heat to escape. This kind of technology can easily outperform our current propulsion methods and make human space travel very accessible. There is also another route for safe nuclear-powered rockets, the fusion reactors, because fusion processes release up to 4 times as much energy as fission reactions. Fusion propulsion might theoretically beat fission-based propulsion. However, the technology is not as advanced and faces various hurdles, including producing and retaining the plasma and efficiently turning the energy produced into focused jet exhaust. But what if you wanted to reach Mars even faster? If this is the case, ion engines may be the best next choice. Unlike chemical rockets, many scientists are investing substantially in developing these ion engines to determine how strong these futuristic inventions may be. Ion engines would accelerate electrically charged atoms known as ions through an electric field, propelling the rocket ship forward in an incredible manner. However, once in space, the charged ions will be giving the rocket ship a continuous push, similar to the wind pushing a sailboat. This type of propellant would get the rocket ship moving far faster than a typical chemical rocket. It might take you only about 39 days to reach the red planet. Another possible propulsion method is plasma propulsion. Sounds like sci-fi? Well, not quite. Ad Astra Rocket Company, located in Costa Rica and the United States, stated over the summer that it has completed an 88-hour high-power endurance test of its Vasimir VX-200SS plasma rocket at 80 kilowatts. The test, which took place at the company's Texas laboratory near Houston, established a new high-power global endurance record in electric propulsion. The variable scientific impulse magnetoplasma rocket, Vasimir rocket, was planned to fly with an engine that heats plasma to 2 million degrees using nuclear reactors. Hot gas is then directed out of the rear of the engine through magnetic fields, allowing it to travel at speeds of up to 123,000 miles per hour, 197,950 kilometers per hour. Despite the fact that Vasimir rockets would send nuclear reactors flying through space at extraordinary speeds, the purpose of Ad Astra is to make considerably faster, but also much safer, spaceflight conceivable. Despite the fact that Vasimir launch vehicles will still require chemical rockets to reach space, once there they will embark on a journey to transform space travel as we know it. There is no doubt that these new propulsion methods can literally change space travel, allowing humans to travel to Mars and beyond in a very short period of time as compared to our current technology. All of these potentially prospective modes of travel might drastically alter how humans navigate the cosmos if we are genuinely able to reduce the length of time it takes to reach Mars and other planets. There is no doubt that a new golden age of space has started, and a lot more of it is yet unexplored. The possibilities are immense. So what do you think about these new propulsion methods? Which one will ultimately come out as a winner? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. It encourages us to keep on making high quality content for you.